It's on 93 Boxing. I'm back with a quick video.
This is going to be my keys to victory, my final keys to victory for Danny Garcia and Keith Thurman. Now, do let me know whether you hate me or you think I'm a good, my channel is a good boxing channel. Let me know if you think a YouTube channel should make a long, should they, when they do keys to victory and predictions, or what, especially keys to victory, what both fighters need to do. Should they make one long video explaining both what both fighters need to do, or should they make separate videos for each fighters? Do let me know that. I'll try. I'll see if it's too long. Maybe I'll make separate videos for each fighters. Otherwise, I'll just make one video, as long as it's too not too long. I'll try keep it simple. I try to go. I sometimes go rambling on about nonsense, but let me go. Let me say shit. Let me say some shit. Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman's more for. He's a boxer puncher. He can box. He can do a variety of different things. But in this fight, I feel like Keith Thurman needs to be a boxer first. And Keith Thurman is looking for this knockout, this one time mentality. He wants to live up to his one time reputation. He hasn't had a knockout in a long time. And obviously Angel Garcia hype, kind of pissed him off in his recent videos. You can see that Keith Thurman is a bit, agitated. I mean, I guess when you're making weight, you'll be agitated. But he's never really like this. I feel like Angel Garcia has something to do with it. He has something to do with it. Plus, he's going up against an undefeated champion. This is definitely his biggest stage. I think so. And Keith Thurman, he's gonna try to put up a knockout. And if he does, it'll be spectacular because Danny Garcia has some granite chin. I feel like Keith Thurman can win, but I feel like those things that he needs to do to win, he won't do it. So these are, in my opinion, what are some of the things that he needs to do. Keith Thurman, he has better foot speed, and I feel like he can outpoint people, most people, on the long range. So he doesn't have the best jab, but he still has a jab. He can use it often, and he has good reach over Danny Garcia. He has to move around. Now keep in mind, I kind of want him to do similar to what Amir Khan should have done and what Lamont Peterson should have done. Lamont Peterson did a bit too less in that fight, and even Keith Thurman said that. Amir Khan did a bit too much of what Keith, like, he did a bit too much, man. He could have, like, lowered his punches down. So basically what I'm saying is Keith Thurman should have boxed like Amir Khan in the long ranges, but not exactly like Amir Khan, because keep in mind these fighters are all different. Amir Khan, Lamont Peterson, Keith Thurman, like all those three fighters can, all those two fighters, the Khan and Peterson, can pivot pretty well, but Thurman doesn't seem to be able to do that, and they all have a better jab. That's not discrediting Thurman. I'm just saying that Thurman has some disadvantages and some advantages. The disadvantage, obviously, he doesn't jab well enough to keep pivot, but he has to be able to try box. He has a decent, very decent jab, and he has to be able to outpoint Danny Garcia. And through which, yeah, he has some disadvantages, but he does have an advantage, which is massive power over Amir Khan and Lamont Peterson. And the thing about his power is he has more power against Danny Garcia. More power than Danny Garcia, but he tends to load up on those shots, and you can see it coming a lot of times. Someone who has a good eye like Danny Garcia can see it. So what he has to do, the first shot, I want him to throw a few hard shots here and there, like a jab and a loaded right. I don't want him to throw his, all of his power shots, all of his shots through loaded power and shit, because Danny Garcia will be able to counter him. Just imagine the shit that Keith Thurman was doing in the training, and he always does, jumping with left hooks, jumping with hot loaded punches. Danny Garcia will knock him out if he does that. What he has to do, if he's gonna jump in, he has to cover up, but he has to jump in with jabs, he has to jump in with straight punches, and keeping a good guard. He has to, in my opinion, still throw some hard shots, but let's say he throws a jab, right hand, left hook. The first punch should not be a power, like a heavy loaded shot, just because when you throw a heavy, like a loaded cock back shot, it tends to be very, it tends to be like, it's predictable. You can see it coming. But when you throw, like, right after a jab, maybe, it's more, you're more likely to hit it. You're just more likely to hit it. Your opponent's less likely to see it. They're probably distracted by the jab or the other pity patty punches that you're throwing before the hard shot comes in. Keith Thurman really has to do that, and I think he's capable of doing it. I just don't think he has a tendency to do it. He probably has been li winning fights through landing, loading, loading up hard shots. He can land loaded hard shot, but you know, I feel like Garcia is a smart fighter, and he will try and adapt to that. Kitama needs to use his jab. A lot of things he needs to come off, some pity-patty punches, some straight punches. He needs to move around. But you know, he has to definitely, in a combination, 3-4 punch combination, he has to keep his combination low as the fight goes on to preserve his stamina. And also, you know, Garcia will try and adapt to get his timing and everything, try and catch Thurman. But see, what he also has to do is, within those 3-4 punch combination, he has to land one hard shot. Maximum two, but one. And you know, those shots, he has to land it well enough so that Danny Garcia is, you know, he has to get some respect from Danny Garcia, in the sense that Danny Garcia, he has to make Danny Garcia come forward, by the way, while he's moving around. But you know, and then he has to, pretty much like how Danny Garcia was trying to chase up Amir Khan and shit, and just like how he was trying to chase up Lamont Peterson, Kitama has to kind of make Danny Garcia do that a little bit. But you know, Kitama has to come in with jab, hard right, real hard right. I don't know about the left uppercut. I understand Danny Garcia kind of ducks and tries to throw the hook. Thurman should cover up and throw a left uppercut, which he has a devastating left uppercut with. He can hurt people. But see, he has to, like, as I said, he has to get Garcia's respect. He has to get it early, because you know, Garcia's the underdog. He has the underdog mindset. But you know, it's good to try and get him a little bit under, you know, take away his confidence a little bit. Get in there. You know, Garcia will try to come forward if you make him come forward, obviously. But when you throw them hard shots and you move away, it's very hard to get you. But when you are there, Thurman's getting off with one or two real hard shots, that Garcia will realize that, oh shit, I can't just walk right through him. I can't just go, you know, it's not as easy as I to get him. And when I do get him, he's landing some real hard shots. You know, Danny Garcia might think like that. And Keith Thurman, as the fight progresses, he has to box a bit more. And those he has to throw punches that are not as loaded, but occasionally he has to throw loaded punches. He has to keep his punch combination down. He has to move around, but he still has to, I'm not saying he has to throw pity-patty punches, but some punches that still have some weight to it, but not loaded, not something that he can see it coming, that Garcia can see it coming, right? And, just try to be more awkward, man. Maybe try and give him angles. I don't see Keith Thurman giving people angles all that much, just like, not, he does, but I don't see him pivoting a lot. I don't see him using his jab as often. One thing Keith Thurman tends to do, and he must not do this, and I think, did I mention in this video? I don't know, man, because I've tried to make this video so many times, I'm fucking it up. I've really fucked it up. But you know, if I make any mistakes, says fuck it, just listen to it. Keith Thurman, he's trying to get a knockout, because obviously Angel Garcia pissed him off. He hasn't had a knockout in a while. He will try and get a knockout. And he said it himself. I think he's trying. I mean, they're both trying to get a knockout, but Danny Garcia says that. But he'll try. They're both, you know, if the knockout comes, it comes. But if it doesn't, try and box, be ready for 12 rounds. And, you know, Keith Thurman has to try and box him. Few hard shots. If Garcia gets hurt, then go for the knockout. If not, don't bother. That's what Keith Thurman has to do. But Keith Thurman, look, he's, a lot of times against Porter, against a lot of fighters, he tends to jump in with left, right hands. Do you see when he was trying to trade with Porter, like the right hand, left hook? Man, you do not want to do that with Danny Garcia. You so do not want to do that. If Keith Thurman tries to do that often, from round one, if he starts doing that, he's going to get knocked out in round two. Honestly, if Keith Thurman starts doing that, honestly, that's what I genuinely think. Keith Thurman has to kind of, he has to show his power, but with straight shots and move around. Danny Garcia, you know, he is very good at these wild shots coming in, and Thurman's very loaded. That's the difference between Garcia's and Thurman's power. Garcia, even when he doesn't load up, like, when Thurman doesn't load up, it just throws a quick shot, like a quick one. Just a quick one, not loading up and shit. It's not a hard punch. But Garcia's one is a hard punch. Even when I see it on TV, Garcia's, even when he doesn't load up, when he throws partially arm punches, it's a hard shot. It's a decently hard shot. His soft punches, Keith Thurman punches harder when they both try to hit as hard as they can. And you know, Guerrero will say that, he asked Robert Guerrero if you don't believe that. But his softer punches, the softer punches that he tends to throw in the ring, I feel like they're softer than Danny Garcia's soft punches. So it's kind of like, I don't know, Keith Thurman has a bigger range of power that he throws within the punches that he tends to throw at his opponent. But yeah, that's the thing about Garcia. He may not hit as hard as Thurman when they go for max power, but Garcia, will, if Thurman tries to load up like that, Garcia will slip and just throws a hard shot, and he might not just see a shot coming in, man. That's really all I think. See, like when this, I was seeing Keith Thurman's training video at one point, and like was it an all axis or some shit? But Thurman was like jumping with right hand, left hook. They're hard shots, but damn, Garcia will catch you with something, man, if you do that. On like body shots here, he's open everywhere, man. He's open, he's telegraphed. But you know, that's, I feel like, well, that's what Keith Thurman needs to do. And you know, I'm gonna quickly go through what Danny Garcia needs to do. I'll try to keep the video as short as I can. Danny Garcia, look, I feel like Keith Thurman will be open, even if he tries to be, you know, a fighter does what they do, you know, when things get rough, when the things get tough. They go back to their instincts because they've been practicing, they've been doing it like that for so long. Like, Americano tends to keep his hand low. A lot of fighters tend to keep their hand low because they probably have they're getting tired, but also they probably have a habit of keeping their hands low. It's just recently they try to keep their hands up, but when they get tired, when it gets too difficult, they can't remember. You know, when you get tired, you go to your instincts. When shit gets stressful, you do what your instincts always have been known to do. So, and you know, those instincts can, you can instinctively learn some bad habits throughout your career if you've been doing it for too long. So yeah, let's see what Danny Garcia needs to do. Danny Garcia, he needs to use his footwork. Honestly, the Danny Garcia before, the recent Danny Garcia, I feel like he beat Keith Thurman, but the previous ones, I don't think they could beat Keith Thurman, just because, you know, Keith Thurman tried to do what Amerikan done properly, and you know, he still has some power. But this, you know, Danny Garcia, he can. He has good footwork. He's not as slow as people think. He's definitely not as slow. And not even his footwork is as slow as what people think. It may not be as fast as Thurman, but it's, in my opinion, better footwork. Foot speed is great, but he has better footwork, in my opinion, Danny Garcia. And he sort of, he has great balance. Like, when he takes a step, kind of when he leans on the side, let's say he leans on one side, Danny Garcia tends to step a little bit. You know, he steps with it as well. And, you know, that's kind of what he does. I also link a video down from Fight Tips, and you'll see a drill. And if you do that drill, and you shadow box, and you try to throw a jab, throw a right hand, you realize that what you're doing kind of looks like Danny Garcia, but when you're doing it, you realize how good it is. But when you see someone else do it, it doesn't look all that much. I'll just link it down. You know, when Danny Garcia tends to lean, he tends to keep his foot, he steps with it as well. While Keith Thurman, Lamont Peace, and a lot of fighters, they kind of just lean without changing where the foot is. The difference between that, they can carry more power on the shots, because a lot of times power is, or lack of power or more power, is due to how well you're balanced when you throw the shot. And Danny Garcia is very balanced with that. He can take a good shot for that reason. He's, and you know, yeah, it just gives them better leverage and shit like that. So Danny Garcia's footwork is better. He really has to do that. He really has to feint with his feet like he always does. He has to go change levels, head, body, feint to the head, come to the body, feint to the body, come to the head. Use his jab. He has to really establish his jab. And Danny Garcia has a good jab. I feel like he needs to use it a bit more. He has to come with not the most hardest punch, because again, everyone that throws hardest punch can be a little bit loaded. He's not as loaded as Thurman, but he doesn't want to give Thurman the chance because Thurman has a lot of power. Regardless of how good your chin is, you can be hurt. And Danny Garcia has taken big shots, but he has been hurt, right? He didn't wobble or nothing, but you know, if he felt Judas' punches, he was a bit stunned. I'm fairly sure he felt Matisse's punches a little bit, but Judas' punches definitely hurt him, where he has a lot of snap, just didn't see it coming. So, you know, I feel like Danny Garcia has to have great balance. He has to use the jab. He has to keep a good eye out. He doesn't always, you know, he shouldn't be always looking for the big shot. He has to really cut the ring off well, but he has to have a good eye, and he has to just literally be sharp, be really sharp. Anything Keith Thurman throws, let's say he comes in with a jab, he tends to keep his hands low, counter him on the just, you know, right hand. Quick, Danny Garcia's got underrated quick right hand, like a, not let's say lead right hand, because he doesn't lead with it, but lead just a little bit, quick right hand, like he did against Peterson. He was catching Peterson with that early. He has to do that. That in that way, you can take away Keith Thurman's jab, because jab is pretty low. You could hit Keith Thurman, maybe slip a jab and hit him to the body. You could test his body, and if Keith Thurman is coming in wild, you just counter him, man. Just sit down and counter him, but effectively counter him, smart counter. Keep a chin tucked under, just like, you know, if I was Danny Garcia, this is the advice I would give him, obviously, but obviously, who am I to give him advice? He's got a trainer, he's a fighter himself. He would keep his, he needs to keep his chin tucked and everything. I know he's a good chin, but that man's got some power, man. He's got some speed as well. So he has to be careful with that. He really has to, whatever Keith is trying to do, Garcia just has to be sharp. He has to use his footwork more than he did against the Khan fight. He has to really be sharp. He has to use body movement, which he has more than Keith Thurman. You know, lean maybe on the side. He's very good at slipping, like lean on the side. At least better than Keith Thurman on the slipping. Lean and counter. The right hand will be key. The right hand has to be key. Right hand to the head, right hand to the body. Test Keith Thurman to the body, to the head, and just really counter punch. Be smart, be crafty. That's what Danny Garcia has to do. And I feel like what I described of what Danny Garcia needs to do, what Keith Thurman needs to do, I feel like I'm missing a few things of what Danny Garcia needs to do. But whatever I described and whatever I feel like Danny Garcia needs to do to win the fight, he will, you know, he has good body movement and things like that. He has to use all that. And I feel like he has the capability, and I've seen the capability, especially in his recent fights, to use all that. And as he uses it, and sorry, rather, you know, the fact that he'll be able to use it, in my opinion, and I've seen him use it before, you know, it makes me think that Danny Garcia will win. The fact that he's used it in his recent fights, I've seen him use most of these qualities before, I feel like he'll win these fights. But see, the keys to victory I gave to Keith Thurman, these are some things that I've not really, some of them, I've seen Keith Thurman use it in, like, I've seen a lot of what I've said a lot of what not to do for Keith Thurman than Danny Garcia. And if you notice, and you know, some of these things that I've said what Keith Thurman shouldn't do, he ends up doing it considerably a lot. And for those reasons, I feel like Danny Garcia will win the fight. But really, may the best man win. I think Danny Garcia will win. I think they're both great fighters. I just think Keith Thurman is a little bit overrated, just a little bit. Actually, maybe a bit more, because Keith Thurman is, he's not a human being. He's not no god, nothing, man. He's a great fighter. And whoever wins or loses, give them credit. A loss doesn't define anyone. He's right when Keith Thurman said that. A loss doesn't define me. He's still a great fighter. I'm glad these fighters are getting it on. And I like, look, I don't hate Keith Thurman. I like both. He's giving the fans what they want. He's willing to fight these fights. Unlike Kell Brook. That's really all I have to say, man. Let me know what you think. Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm completely wrong? Just let me know what you think. I'm SR93 Boxing. I'm out.